Lero ndukukwasiza Katonda kweyakoda byonna.
Moses Nachintiji Sekiboggo, aka Mose Radio, was born in January 1985. He started his musical career as a student at Holy Cross Lakeview Secondary School in Jinja and later also studied at Chira College Butiki, also in Jinja. In 2004, he joined Leon Island Crew, founded by singer Joseph Mayanja, popularly known as Jose Chameleon, as a backup vocalist. While in the group, he released his solo songs under the Leon Island Crew label. These included Jennifer, Dagara, Wololo, and Sweet Lady.
Sweet Lady, can I please take your number? Maybe later, I would like to know you better.
In 2007, following disagreements between himself and Chameleon, Mose Radio paired with Chameleon's brother Douglas Mayanja, aka Weasel, and formed the Good Life Crew. From 2008 to date, the duo have released hundreds of songs, making them Uganda's top musical crew. Some of the songs include Nakudata, Nakutamani, Bread and Butter, Nambemu, Abirite, Gutamiza, and many more. The Good Life Crew have won several awards both locally and internationally, such as the 2011 Channel All Music Video Awards, which they took as the most gifted African East video for their song This Is How We Do It. Radio Breath is last at dawn on Thursday morning at Case Hospital in Kampala at the age of 34. He became 34 while on his hospital bed.
See, I got something, girl, we need to do. I got something I need, just for me and for you.
Mikey Benda with Muna Kamfala playing for you right here on 88.2 Sanyu FM. I am Crystal and I'd like to welcome my guest right now on Celeb Select. Yeah. One half of Radio and Weasel, that's Mose Radio. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Crystal.
How are you today?
I'm all right.
You're good?
Yeah, well.
I was enjoying this man singing in here just now. The rest of you, I'm sorry, but I had my moment. It's good to have you on the show. How's the weekend? Is it a busy time for you? Do you have performances today?
Well, today I don't have no performances. I was just chilling at home. Like, you know, I told you when we fixed the program, I'm just chilling today.
You're
I'm
just
not
chilling.
Working. Yeah.
Well, I'm happy you're chilling with me right now.
I know.
Okay.
Thank
now,
you.
Just to let you know that we will be going live on Instagram.
Yeah.
So that's to you listening. And if you want to see what's actually happening in the studio, that's sure. Crystal A. Newman. So I would like to know from you where you were born and where you went to school, where it all started.
Well, I come from. I'm rooted from Jinja.
Mm-hmm.
I went to Alliance Nursery School in Jinja still.
Mm-hmm.
Then I went to, when I left Jinja, I went to Chagwe and I studied in Malongwe Primary School for 1 year. Then I left there and I went to Kibye Public Primary School in Kampala here, around Ndeba there.
Mm-hmm.
Then I left Kibye Public Primary School. I went to Lakeview Senior Secondary School from senior 1 up to senior 4. Then I went to Kira College from my senior 5 and senior 6. Then I went to Makere for my, of course, my bachelor's degree in psychology.
Mm-hmm.
And then I pursued my career in
music.
Yeah, because I really love to sing and it's nice to. To, you know, melt you people. Yeah.
Well, we do melt.
Sure.
We do melt. I can't say that
it's
much.
It's nice. It's really wonderful.
You went to so many different schools.
Yeah,
was
sure.
Was that because as a family you were moving? Why was that?
Yeah, we were always moving. We were always on the move.
Mm.
Yeah,
what
from a place to
do?
Place. My parents, what they did, I'd rather not say, but not something that I'm not proud of it, but...
Mm.
I'm only proud that whatever they did, they managed to keep me in school
and
keep me upright. And right now, I'm somebody you can, you know, call on radio to say something.
Yes, that is yeah. true.
Okay. And that's the big part of it, yeah. But they really suffered a bit, I tell you.
Mm.
They had some fingers.
Okay.
Yeah.
And when did your love for music begin? Were you singing when you were little?
Yeah, everybody has been singing. When you were a child, of course, the first one of the first crafts you learn is singing,
mm-hmm.
like nursery rhymes and all.
Mm-hmm.
But what I remember is my mother has always, when I was a little child, my mother used to ask me to learn some songs, some Luganda songs, and sing for her, like the whole song without missing a word, like the whole album. I used to sing like Fred Sebata's albums, like almost all of them. I still remember most of the songs. Yeah. So when she has like visitors at home, she has to ask me to sing for them. Then they clap for me. She buys me gifts and all.
Sweet.
So I've most of the time that I remember, I've been singing,
mm-hmm.
yeah, and I've always loved to sing.
Well, mummies normally spot the talent, yeah. so clearly she's like, ha, there's something there.
Yeah, I guess so.
So when's the first time, like, you performed? Because your mom would make you perform for the visitors.
Yeah, yeah.
When did you perform on stage? Or?
On stage? I studied in school.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time I was performing in school.
Mm-hmm.
I used to be part of the school choir, was a choir master, stuff like that. I used to write songs for my choir in school.
Oh.
So first time, I think it was 2000 years, first time I got on the big stage,
mm-hmm.
and I performed really very well. I won myself the first award, I tell you.
But did you ever get nervous? Do you ever get, you know what they call butterflies? Do you ever feel that?
Well, me, what I'll tell you, I'm always very excited to go and sing. Maybe my butterflies, they just push me to go on stage, because it's really nice to get out there,
mm-hmm.
and get people wild and get some people very emotional.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you get there, some people pay you, you know, right there. They
right
give you
there.
Some of their monies, mm-hmm. and it's nice to have some.
Mm-hmm.
So I won't say I have butterflies to go and sing on stage. I just get butterflies before I can sing a song, like before I can record a song,
because
I don't know how it's going to sound. But if I already sang the song and you guys are really excited about it, I don't get no butterflies.
Oh, you're like, okay,
I don't even get
well.
Doves. I don't get nothing. I just feel good, you know. Yeah.
Okay, you said you used to sing, you used to write songs for the school choir.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Okay, so are you almost like classically trained as well when it comes to music?
No.
So you just sit down and
seriously, I've not had any music training, like serious music training. I dropped my music lessons in senior two.
Okay.
Yeah.
How do you, because you know when someone is not a musician, they're not an artist, they don't understand how a song comes to you.
Yeah.
Do you just hear the melody or?
Well, if I have to tell you, I have to kill you, like say.
Aww.
Because I'll be giving you my secret of all secrets.
You never know, maybe you dream the song.
I can give you a little sneak peek. It's exactly how you go through life. What you go through, so many other people go through it. And if you talk about it, so many other people don't have the time to listen to you. But if you sing it, everybody wants to listen, maybe to the beat. And it's a great story, I'm telling. I went through such and such. And then I know you also go through the same stories and we share a moment. So that's basically it.
I think
the others, it's you find out.
Okay.
Or you want to be a musician.
I wanted to see, maybe you dream and in the middle of the night at 3 a.m. you're like, aha, I've got a song. And you start writing.
Oh, okay, also that some other people, they just, they can imagine, because it's creating stuff that is not there. So you can still imagine.
Mm.
But most rich music is real music. It's talking about real things. It's not imagining
real
fairy
stories.
Tales and what, like you're going to fly like Peter Pan. No, that's a little bit extreme. So most of it is what you go through, what you listen to, other people go through, stuff like that. Yeah.
Okay.
It's easier to tell.
Well, now we want to know the kind of music you like. So this is a request show.
Sure.
I'd like to know your first request, a pick of an international song.
Well, I would like you to play for me Mirror by Justin Timberlake.
Mm.
I like the song. It's wonderful. It talks to me.
It talks to you.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
It's okay. Beautiful. You want to tell us more? What does it say exactly?
Well, there's so much that could have happened. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Then there's so much that already happened.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much that we could have stopped to happen. Mm-hmm. It already happened. Mm-hmm. You know? So okay. Just look in the mirror. We're just human.
People sure. Are deep here. Here it is, Mirrors from Justin Timberlake. Alone, the glare makes me hard to find. This world that I'm always parallel on the other side. Cause we're going. Now, what name were you given when you were born?
When I was born,
mm-hmm.
I was given a name,
mm-hmm.
Sekiboggo,
mm-hmm.
Nakinti J,
mm-hmm.
Niejira,
mm-hmm.
Moses.
And what does that mean?
Plus others. Others
you have more, please?
Yeah.
Tell us.
So many nicknames. Tiny.
Okay.
Big ears.
Big ears.
So many others. I had so many nicknames, yeah. But
Yeah. So growing up, were you in school, were you the quiet guy? Were you the loud guy? Were you the troublemaker?
I would not say I was the quiet one. I would not say I was the loud one. I would not say much, but I was somewhere in between. I would make some noise when I had to.
Mm-hmm.
I would be quiet when I could. Of course, when I could, and but most of the time I was one of the loud guys
around.
Yeah, I really love to talk about stuff. You know,
mm-hmm.
you know, tell people about movies I'd watched. You know, stuff like that.
Do you still watch a lot of movies?
I do, but nowadays not so much. I really love to watch like wildlife, like Discovery Channel, like yeah, stuff like that. I want to see what is going on in the world, like watch the news.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're not one of those people, you spend the whole weekend watching a series.
Not so much, really.
I
wouldn't say. At least I think I spend most of the time in studio.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then I would spend watching a movie, because really, most of the movies, they're just fiction.
Mm-hmm.
But most of what we see on that Geo Wild is real. You know, it's the real in the wild. You see a real animal eating another. You know, there are no jokes about it.
That's interesting. It says a lot about you. I mean, you like to sing about real stories, real life, and then you also like to watch, you know, real stories.
Yeah. Well,
Nature Channel. So does that mean you don't have much patience for fiction?
No. I'm not saying I detest them. I can watch them.
Okay.
Yeah, but I don't prefer them over what I would call real.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
They come second.
Okay. Sure. Okay, fine. You said you went to Makerere University.
Yeah.
And you got yourself a degree in psychology.
Yeah.
How did you end up doing psychology?
Well, I loved psychology. I had a good talk about psychology. Some inspirational speakers came to KeFeL College and they spoke to us.
Mm.
I initially wanted to do law, but somehow when those guys talked to me, and I felt like psychology would be a very instrumental part of what I wanted to do, because I've always wanted to be a musician.
Mm-hmm.
But if I would learn how people really behave, you know, how people think,
mm-hmm.
what causes what, mm-hmm. you know, all that, if I had it on my side, part of my creation of the music would be quite easy, because I have a little knowledge behind, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it gives you a better understanding of people.
Sure. So I thought it would be a good ally.
Mm.
Yeah,
so it was a strategic decision.
I would say.
You would say?
Yeah.
Okay. So then you decided, okay, now I'm going to pursue my musical career. How did it all begin?
Well, I met, that time when I was still in school, I used to be a barber. So I was working at a small barber shop in Endeavor there.
Really?
Yeah, sure. I'm a good barber.
Oh.
I'm so good. I'm too proud even. Well, so I was working at a barber shop there in Endeavor. And I met Chaga. Chaga was passing by most of the time in the evenings to go and have a haircut somewhere in another barber shop. So I always wanted him to come around where we were working.
Mm-hmm.
One time he comes there, we start talking to him. I sing for him. He thinks I sing well. Then mm-hmm. he arranges a meeting between me and Chameleon.
Mm-hmm.
And then I meet Chameleon. Then Chameleon records my first song. Then the rest is history.
No, it's not history. We need to know. Yeah, about so that part.
I record my first song. I become backup musician for Jose Chameleon. I also become driver for Chameleon and everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, I was still in school. I was still in university.
When so you were juggling all that.
Yeah,
at the same
I was
time.
Doing. Yeah, all of it at the same time. So I was driver, backup, and at the same time student,
mm-hmm.
and upcoming superstar.
Upcoming so, superstar.
Yeah. after that, when I finished university, then I had enough time mm-hmm. to concentrate on the music.
Mm-hmm.
I went to studio, recorded a couple of songs. Some of them did not hit so much, but they were wonderful pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Then we started working with Wizzo, you know,
mm-hmm.
out of just a joke. Let's go to studio, just bored at home.
Had
Let's
you met him? Did you know each other before?
Yeah, he was, of course, I was working with him. We were all backups for Jose Chameleon,
yeah, but
we had never sung like a song together. Uh-huh. I used to back him also. I used to be backup for Wizzo also when he sang all those wonderful things.
Uh-huh.
He had so many other pieces.
Uh-huh.
So this one time, Wizzo comes at home and says, "Now we're just bored. Yeah, let's just go to studio and sing a song."
Mm-hmm.
Went to studio, sang Nakudata, became mm-hmm. a blockbuster. Went back, we sang so many others, became blockbusters, and we're still singing more. That is how it started. But I want to tell you, I don't know the magic behind it. All I know is I try to work my sitting facility off, you know,
mm-hmm.
if I would say the word. So maybe it's the hard work that pays off,
mm-hmm.
or it's the blessing from the Almighty. I want to, I think it's mostly about the blessing, because
mm-hmm.
we are all trying to look for who we really are in this world.
Mm-hmm.
Until you place yourself where you belong, then you don't get the blessing. So
mm-hmm.
if my blessing is in the music, I thank the Almighty for that, because I really love it and it's working magic, I tell you.
Oh, it is.
Yeah,
it
sure,
is.
Sure.
I am now going to ask you for your second request, an
yeah.
African song. Mm. And you picked African Queen.
Yeah, African Queen. I would like to tell you about African Queen.
Mm.
When I was beginning, I used to perform at Blue Africa and National Theater. But at Blue Africa, I did not have a lot of songs to sing.
Mm.
I had Jennifer, and I didn't have any other. So to keep the people listening to you, I had to sing another song.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, fortunately, at that time, I Two-Face had released African Queen, and nobody knew it here that much. I got the CD from Chaga. I had gone with Chameleon to Tanzania, so
mm-hmm.
they got an autographed CD from Two-Face Debia. They brought
mm-hmm.
it here. He wanted people to promote his music in
here.
Uganda,
uh-huh.
and oh, how nice. I received that song. I fell in love with the song. I started singing it at Blue Africa. And I used to get lots of money, you know. They call
and
Okufuwa.
I'm sure all the ladies were also like,
"What?" I tell you, they almost thought it was me. Oh, so it's a wonderful piece. It started my career. Those are the songs I really remember when I was beginning.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, here it is. Sure. It's still beautiful. African Queen from Two-Face.
Yeah, yeah, you are my African queen. Ooh, Lord, ooh, Lord.
Mose from Radio Nweezel here with me on Select, and he's just been singing to African Queen. You got to meet Two-Face. Did you ever tell him story? Did you tell him that you used to sing his song?
I told him, man, I almost stole your song, man. It was the most wonderful song I ever sang. But I met him, and mm-hmm. he was so glad that I told him that, because, you know, it's nice to tell those people that you learned from a few things mm-hmm. about your craft, you know.
Yes.
Some people never get to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
They just want to copy you and just run away with your craft, and they don't want to appreciate.
That's true.
But we felt so good, and whatever he told me that time, I still hold dear to it,
mm-hmm.
and I'm still growing strong every day.
Yeah. Who are the musicians that you have looked up to over the years who've inspired you? You listen to their sound and you're like, wow,
mm.
make you a better musician as well.
Mostly I love to listen to reggae music.
Reggae.
Because reggae is soul music,
mm-hmm.
but it's not described as soul,
mm-hmm.
as soul for the reggae artist, you know. The soul that people know is different kind of soul. It's the kind of soul I don't listen to. So I listen to reggae because it's my kind of soul. It's nice. It speaks to me. There's a lot there. There's a lot of suffering and there's a lot of victory. There's, you know, there's so much there in reggae music, you know. There's a lot of spirit there, spiritual message. There's a lot of inspirational message. There's too much in reggae that you can get that you won't get in other kinds of music, because it's soul to me and soul to the, you know, the reggae lovers. They do know that. But other guys who love the other kind of soul, it's different.
It's a different... You've worked with so many different people, collaborations. Yeah. Are there any that have stood out for you
over the collaborations that we have done?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, most of them, they've really done some good job.
Are there any that just... You know, because sometimes, you know, you hear musicians saying, oh, you know, I just met this person. And then we said, oh, let's just try and do a song together. And then something amazing happened. Did you ever have any of those magical moments, which were just by chance almost?
Yeah, but I'll tell you true. Like if you want me to speak the truth.
Yes.
Most of my of the music that we do is by chance.
Most of it.
I'll tell you true. Because I don't go to the studio with any song. I just go to the studio. I meet the producer there. I meet everybody there. And we just come up with a song. So it's all by accident, I'll tell you true. That's why I told you in the beginning, I'll attribute it to the almighty blessing, because it's a blessing. Maybe I just met what I'm good at. But we don't have any system that we follow, that if you do it like this, this is a blockbuster. So most of these songs that we do, they're just mistakes or like lucky mistakes. Like you collide with a song, it's an accident, and then you collide with a good one. You know, nobody goes to the studio to sing a bad one. Me, I don't want to go to studio to sing a bad song. You should, if you meet me in studio and I walk with a producer and I don't feel the track, I don't feel the track, I go outside, I try to confuse the guy about and I disappear, because I know I'm going to sing a bad one and nobody's going to listen to it. Nobody's going to love it, even myself, because I have to listen to a song, I don't know, about 1,000 times before I can release it. I have to listen to it until I get sick of it, you know. Like I get sick of goodness.
Okay, so you keep, do you keep changing little things here and there the whole way? You're like, oh, that has
yeah, you
good
can change,
that
but
is...
most times when the first time you do the song, that's the best time always. Those other times you try to change is because it is beginning to infect you somehow. It's beginning to be nice, so you want to add all the other nice things that you know about songs. But I know the first time when you do it, that's the best part.
That's the best take.
Huh? Like usually, I don't want to do the second take. I want to take the very first one. If it's good enough, if I've not like, if I've not errored, I've not made like flats and sharps and what, and I'm still on key properly, I would rather keep that one than go back
and
to redo
key.
It, because the vibe is not the same. Yeah, it's not the same. The music these days, the music has to communicate to you. Even you have to know exactly what this guy is talking about, even when you don't know what he's saying. Like the tonation of the voice, if it's sad, then you know it must be a sad story. If it's a bit happy, then must be maybe a happy song or stuff. Yeah, all those.
Okay. Sure. So in terms of collaborations, is there anyone now that you're looking at that you want to work with?
Yeah. Looking at Snoop Lion.
Yeah.
Snoop Lion.
How did that happen?
I tell you.
That's so exciting. So exciting.
Yeah, I tell you.
So when are you guys going to get together, or is it still being ironed out?
Yeah, it's coming soon. Just wait. Why don't you wait? You know how we have waited? I've waited to sing with some of these big people like forever. And you know, forever is like forever also. Like you wait and they say you have to wait again. Then you wait and you have to wait again. And you're looking up to them. They have run this game for quite some time.
A long time.
Since we started loving music, they've been rocking it. Like Snoop Dogg, like Dr. Dre, like Busta Rhymes, like, you know, all those great people, you know.
So we're so looking forward.
To have an honor like that, to sing with them from a humble beginning, like I told you, yeah. And stuff that happens by accident, you know. things that just happen, because I don't go to studio prepared with a song. Mm-hmm. I somehow collide with it. I mean, somehow I collide with another one that Snoop Lion is interested in. Holy yes. It's too good, I tell you. It's too good to be too. Hey, another one. Uh-huh. We already have a collaboration with Africa's greatest, by the way. This is PJ Powers. Remember PJ Powers?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have a collaboration with her. Brother, that is also good news for us. I tell you, this year, 2017.
It has started off so good for you. Huh?
So much is happening by magic. Wow, automatic, I don't know. You know, like they say, if you go to, if you met God, sorry to talk about this, but it's important to talk about God.
Mm-hmm.
If you met God somewhere, like, he's sitting in his chair and he asked you, Moses, what do you want? Okay, now, assuming I'm God, and say, Newman, what would you want?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know you may not ask for anything.
I'll just be
it will all flash in your head and say, you know what, let me just go back and think about what I want. Because it can just happen too fast.
Mm-hmm.
And then when also your prayers are answered, they also get answered too fast, you know. Before you say thank you for the first one, there's another one,
mm-hmm.
you know.
So blessings
thanks
on
and
blessings.
Praise to the Almighty One who makes it happen. We're just a vessel. Mm-hmm. So much is yet to happen, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Snoop Lion, that is the icing on the cake.
Okay, so we're waiting for that collaboration mm-hmm. with Snoop Dogg.
Sure.
Any timeline? How long do we have to wait?
Soonest most. Mm-hmm. You see, I know you are also as eager to get it as we are.
Mm-hmm.
Eager to listen to it.
Okay.
But already we are working on two tracks.
Mm-hmm.
There's plenty, you know, plenty.
Mm-hmm.
That one. Yeah, then we are working on another one, which is a surprise. Nobody knows. So Banango, we are also excited about the project. And we are going to deliver as usual.
As usual.
You know what we do.
Uh-huh. So now I'm going to ask you for your third request. And this is a local song that
sure.
you feel was special.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I love this beautiful Juliana.
Mm-hmm.
And this song really made a statement, you know.
Mm.
You know, when we sing these songs that we sing, it's so hard to convince people to come and listen to them, spend their money watching us sing them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm.
And it's nice for some other artist to sing a song that speaks to you, even if you know you are not going to pay for that show, but you know how much it's going to impact on the people who are going to attend that show, who are going to listen to that show, that song for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the people who it's going to speak to, like it speaks to you. So, Juliana, Nabikoa, big up.
Now, you told us that you're a barber, a really good barber.
Yeah, good
mm-hmm.
one. Yeah.
I find that very interesting. Mm-hmm. And then you also said that you like real life stories. So even when you watch on TV, the music you listen to, you like to listen to music that has meaning.
Sure.
And do you feel that as a music industry, we are lacking that? That we don't have enough music with meaning?
Well, kind of, I tell you, it's sad. Because right now there is something they call commercialization of music.
Mm-hmm.
So most of the artists now, they look at the commercial part because that is what is paying the bills, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So it is very sad that the music is kind of dying. We are the artists tending towards, you know, money.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
we are singing what people want to hear. Yeah, we are not singing what we're supposed to sing, you know, not what we're supposed to sing, what the art is really about, because this music is not about let's go to the dance, let's go to you rock it on the dance floor. Oh, you don't know. No, there's so much we can say in music, you know.
Mm-hmm.
we can talk about everything, actually.
Mm-hmm.
We can talk about farming.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we can talk about farming,
if you do it well,
we can talk about global warming, we can talk about, but because music has been commercialized. When you talk about global warming, not so many people would want to play yours, to put your song on replay, you know. But they would rather you say, shake that thing, and I'd be like, oh, that one is fire, you know. So you can see that is the dilemma of the music right now. But
so you're always trying.
We are trying. Yeah, we are trying to bridge it as we are commercial. At the same time, we still want to portray a message behind our commercial music.
Mm.
Now, we beg that all the other artists can embrace that, not just sing what the other people want to listen to.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you can say a bit what they want to listen to, but say what exactly you have to say, because you are a musician. You are mouthpiece, you know. We have to listen to you like gospel. Yeah.
Now, when I invited you on the show, so many people were shocked that you were coming on your own without Weasel. Everyone's like, what? But I'm like, no, you know, with times. I want to ask you about your partner. I think I can almost call him your brother now.
Yeah, sure.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Your journey together, how has it been? Are you the kind that sometimes you also fight, you also get tired of each other?
Not get tired of each other, I would say, but it has been quite a smooth ride.
Mm-hmm.
We pick on each other like everybody else picks on themselves. You see, even lovers in a relationship, they fight sometimes.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but we pick on each other in a good way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if I get pissed off, I will always get pissed off and explode. If he gets pissed off, you get pissed off and you'll explode. And then we understand each other.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no touchy-touchy. No touchy-touchy, no pushy-pushy, you know. Yeah. No. So I think it's been a smooth relationship.
Mm.
I've enjoyed growing together with Weasel.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we started working, we didn't know what to do. We didn't know what's going on, how far we are going to go.
Mm-hmm.
And now we can see it's still, you know, we still have a long way to go. Mm-hmm. So we enjoy each other's company. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Your family.
Do. Yeah. And the good thing is our family still comes with some dollar signs and them. I tell you. What a relationship.
So normally we wrap up Celeb Select when we talk about family. And you are a father.
Yeah, I'm a father.
You are a father. Tell us about your little ones.
Usually I don't like to talk about my little ones. They are very special to me.
Mm-hmm.
They are not very special to some of these people out there. But I'll tell you, I have very beautiful, wonderful children.
How old are they, though?
Yeah.
How old are they?
The oldest is 6.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. And?
Not more than that. They are very special people. I tell you, they are one of the most special people I've ever met in my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to warn you people listening out there, they are going to rock you. If they don't sing, they will treat you.
Yeah. All right. So a lot of ladies are wondering.
Yeah.
Are you seeing someone seriously?
Yeah, of course. Mm. How can I be this handsome and not sing? You guys, don't be funny. I am. Please don't look at me. I am.
Mm-hmm.
I'm seeing and I'm comfortable. But but if you want to fantasize about me, I have so many beautiful videos about myself when I'm trying to act so many poses that I am not.
Mm-hmm.
But big up to that one, the one who keeps my heart at rest.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You can be yourself with her?
I tell you, the one I'm comfortable with. And I big up to all you people with all your the ones that you are comfortable with. I'll keep updating you with wonderful songs so that you keep with that one.
Mm-hmm.
Please don't tamper with mine. I may be skinny, but I have a very big fight inside these tiny muscles, these lean muscles. So yeah, big up, yeah.
All right,
no hats, no hats, man.
So okay, I like what you said, that you know, even though you didn't have a musical background, you know, you had your mother as your fan and you have made it. What's your message to so many people who look up to you?
Yeah.
So many people who are trying to also find it.
We are special.
Mm.
We are the most. You are special. I am special. Everybody is special. Let nobody tell you that you cannot do it. That's what they used to tell me, man.
Mm-hmm.
So you are so special. Treat yourself special. Every day, if you can, you just look yourself in the mirror and tell yourself, I am special. Mm. I am strong. I am a winner. I am not a quitter. I'm going to defeat everybody. I'm going to make it. I'm going to be the greatest.
Mm. So your last song is one of your own. It's a new song. Tell us about this one.
Well, this one is a new one. It's Lesu. Like, you know, wrap yourself up again like you used to wrap yourself when I just met you. We want to take it back to the drawing board.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody feels the first time when you meet some people, when you meet people, it's always special. It's different.
Mm-hmm.
When you meet for all the other consecutive times that you meet, and then a day, and then you fall in love, and then blah, 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 you get married, and then fight, and then fall out of love, and then back, and then blah, 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 all
mm-hmm.
that.
Mm-hmm.
You want to go back to that time when it was just beginning, when she was different, when she was brand new, when you were brand new, when the voice was new.
Lero nduku kwa siza katonda kwe akora byona no musana no kwasa byona vienda bane bye kwese wala kastandi nawe asinga era lumundi bizura byena kwata korero Seko mukono kwo onda kenge kwo onja sise tara katonda tamula nange panguza kolero nange katonda tandika Sezanda getisa Amanyi gomu kwano kwa gamare mobu nafu Mpereza no mugua Ninisa madara Echiro enkuba ya suze fukirira Emiti nebimuri Echokulia tuchisubira Mabega tukulizo lulimi lwange narize mikono jange katonda tamula nange panguza kolero nange katonda tandika nange Sezanda getisa
Radio. Weasel, welcome to my show. How you doing, brother? How you doing?
Everything fresh. Huh? Everything fresh like water and vegetable.
I know you were born in Jinja.
Yeah.
And of course, they say you're in Nyaranda, you're mixed with Musoga. First of all, where is it?
Well, I'm a Ugandan.
He's East African.
I'm a Ugandan, I'm a Kenyan, I'm a Tanzanian.
East African.
We are all Africans, you know. These small boundaries should not really bar us from experiencing what Africa is really made of.
Yeah.
Me, I'm proud to be here. Mm. I'm proud to be a Ugandan. Mm. And my music story is a wonderful one.
Okay, I see you don't want to go there. Okay.
No, but
let's talk about...
Seriously.
Yeah.
Seriously, we are all Africans. Yeah. Why should we say that some are Chinese, some are Japanese? Yeah.
No, but identity is important.
Yes, I'm Ugandan.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Born and bred in Jinja.
So you were born in Jinja?
Yeah.
Where exactly? In Jinja? Well, Jinja or now?
Jinja Town.
Jinja Town.
Then I grew up in Mbiko.
Mbiko.
Some parts of Mafubira.
What were your parents like? What were you doing?
My parents, my mom, she was a food vendor, selling food.
Yeah.
And my dad, a truck driver.
Okay. Yeah. How many are you in the family?
We are six.
Six?
Yeah, minus one.
Pastor. Minus one, yeah. Okay, never seen the others. Which are you, the first, third born?
No, I'm the second born.
You're the second born.
Yes.
You don't see any sisters or yours, brothers.
I would rather they keep their privacy. You know, everybody has their day to shine.
Okay.
Now, this is mine, they'll shine some other day.
Unlike me, so the whole family there.
They do the same thing.
So, Jinja, Noberayo, of course, Bazendebo, Noberayo, primary, second.
Noberayo, primary. One primary.
What's the middle of primary?
Primary one. Nasomera ku Jinja. Jinja Bajita Njeru primary school. Nasare school. Nasoka nasomera ku Alliance. Nasare school. Nemba onengera ku nengenda ku Njeru primary school. Nema nengenda ku Saint Noah. We used to move a lot from places to places. We used to move house.
Because the daddy being a truck driver, that's why you moved around?
Not only that, my mom would not be allowed to stay in the houses for long with kids. You know, they never liked kids. Mm. People with kids, they have noise around. What the kids are going to mess with the walls. The houses were not ours.
Yes. You're just renting.
So it was not because the dad was moving all the time. He always found time to come by.
Yeah.
But the old woman would not be allowed in one house for long because it would make a lot of noise.
Six kids.
There's a lot of beating in the house, too much stubbornness. So
a lot of
make a lot of noise with the neighbors. We had to move house most of the time.
Yeah.
When you move house, sometimes it's a distance, then you change school.
I
changed a couple of schools in primary, but then
secondary
school I settled somehow. I went to Lakeview Senior Secondary School in one year again, and then I finished my senior four from there. Then I went to Kira College. But half in the middle there, I went to Saint Noah back. Saint Noah Mawagari for a term. Now at that time, I was kicked out of school.
Okay. And your singing, when did it start? Did it start primary?
My singing?
Secondary?
No. It started way back. I started singing for my mom and my siblings at home. Because my mom, whenever she had visitors, she asked me categorically to sing for them Sebata songs.
Oh, Sebata. I was about to ask which songs.
She used to buy a new album, then I have to listen to it.
Then
I go through.
What was your favorite Sebata
song? Oh,
many.
Same one.
Just one.
Koko koko gula omunange mbwangu. Lady Mno Zempita, Nava Wanu Kavayo. Big up, please don't make this
legend.
I learned most of my early singing was about those songs.
Mm.
Then as I progressed with my, you know, refining myself, I didn't know I was trying to practice for the job because I was trying to entertain my family, my mom, and she used to like that.
When do you now start Of course, now you've left. When did you leave Jinja now? Jinja Nova?
Jinja. I left Jinja like Okuvayo Dala when I finished my senior six. That was in, when was that? 2000 some year. So I left 2000 some year. I came to Kampala. Of course, I was living in Kampala and Jinja at the same time.
Because
my mom, she had already moved.
Oh, she moved
now from Jinja to here. But in Jinja, I was staying with my uncle Ernest, and my auntie Sylvia. So I was staying in Bukaya for quite some time. But I was staying in Bukaya and Kampala.
Full stop. Oshimanyi era mundeva o mamu yabira ngatwalindira ba neighbors. My granddad yabira.
From Japan.
I mean, to be happening, it was in God's plan, man.
So it is very interesting. We have stayed almost my same places nearby.
Family.
But the family knew each other.
No.
My mom knows you.
Kati mama wawa, ya manyi mama wafe, ya manyi family yafe yeyo. Kati for me to know about that mama ono, ya manyi about my mom. Na manyi aluvanyu manyo, the other guys they were friends, but from here it was a God's plan.
Okay, so no jano, kambia mchizungu?
It was okay, mundeva.
Ngira
food vendor. She was vending there in Chibuye there. Then from there I started my name Tango Kusoma University.
Makerere.
I joined Makerere.
What were you? Remember you graduated Wasoma Coast?
Yeah, community psychology.
Okay.
Yeah.
So my personal doctor.
When I started studying there, then I met Chaga. Big up on yourself, Chaga, big papa. Large up on yourself, ya mafia, start me business.
And that's why, by the way, people even like ask Mbo Chaga, which people keep saying, Mbo Baba Mugobe. Only the story, Jeva, Chaga's side. That's it, brother.
We start the business.
Continue.
So now, you meet Chaga at campus. Chaga was already with Chameleon.
I did not meet him at campus. I met him in Deva there. I was working at a barber shop, my brother's barber shop.
Gori Baba.
Yeah, I was a barber. Big up on yourself, Secondy Frank, man. You've been a good brother, man. And still be. I was a barber there. Very good one. I can have your head in a few minutes. I was working there. And then Chaga would come around sometimes, maybe for a shave and all. And I could sing, and then also draw pictures. So somehow I got introduced to
a
Chaga.
Very good artist. He can draw you with a pen. No pencil, no rubbing. He's a very good artist. He doesn't pay more than he's getting paid, man.
So many things you have to do. Choose one. So I met Chaga. And then Chaga introduces me to Chameleon. But before,
how did this happen?
Of course, I sang for Chaga a couple of songs. But that time I was singing mostly English songs, R. Kelly style, what? Hey, I tell you, So when I sang for him like Joe style, he told me, "Man, brother, I don't know how I'm going to help you, but this music. If you could only tone it down a little, make it Luganda-ish a bit. Would it is Avantunga and Zay, listen to Avantunga Semboga, listen to Chameleon, listen to Maddox, listen to people who are, would it is Avantunga, would it is? Then I said, okay. I went back, I came, I think it was about after a day, I had already written a song. So I sang for him and he said, okay, fine. Jennifer.
Okay.
Then he said, now I can introduce you to my boss, then you can start work. And that's one thing led to another. There was a show.
How was your meeting with the
Will tell you about it. There was a show at Resort Beach. I think it was Firebase versus Leon Island. That was the show. So before Chameleon gets on stage, Chaga calls me and introduces me to Camille and says, this is the boy I was telling you about. Guy sings so well. So Camille says, sing for me. Then I sang for him. Before I even could go like to where I want to impress him, he say, okay, fine, you sing very well. Chaga, bring this boy for work tomorrow. What? He melted my heart, man. Big up on yourself, Joseph Mayanja, man. You're a great boy. You're a great boy. Big up. Large up on yourself, Mafia. Yeah, man, your truth help kickstart my business. So, I made this.
Second hill.
Yeah, so, so we leave the show. I'm very excited, of course. I drive Chaga home and what. Then I have to
you
go.
Are driving, man?
I could, of course. I'm a Mafia. Don't you know? So, I go. And then I meet Cameron for the first time. But I tell you before.
Where was the, again, Machidi?
Nyanama now.
Nyanama.
So, okay. When I go to Cameron's gate, it's this guy, Bamitani, our brother, Tikita.
Tikita.
Large up on yourself, Tikita.
I thought Tikita had
by that time, Yariwa Cameron, they are singing together. He was in Leon Island.
That baby to Mubanja.
That Mubanja, Yabba artist to Cameron.
Leon Island, Mubanja.
So, I meet Tikita. Tikita opens for me the gate. And then he tells me, but right now he's sleeping. Maybe you come back later. But I could not miss the chance. I had already sketched a very nice picture of Chameleon holding a stick. Wajita Mambo Bado, that album.
Yeah,
I had the album. So I just sketched and I drew for him like a picture. Nemgamba, you know what? If I cannot see him when he wakes, just give him this and tell him Moses was here. And then this guy sees the picture, so nice, he could not resist waking the man up. So he ran to the house, woke Chameleon up and asked him to come and see this guy. Chameleon gets out, he's very excited, looks at the picture, looks at the small boy and say, is it you who drew this picture? And I tell him, yeah, of course it's me. I say, you told me you know how to sing. I say, of course. I say, how are you singing? You sing for me? That is how I started. He got me to studio right there. He made the beats for Jennifer as I'm singing along.
Made the beats?
Yeah, right there. And then there's another guy who came through, Samike. Samike came, I think he's a backup artist also. He's helping Cameleon, backing some songs and all. He met me there and was trying to give me props for the backups. So basically, that's how it started. And he recorded this song.
Jennifer.
Okay, now, Weasel, how do you then meet radio?
So they record a song with Chameleon.
Yeah.
By the time I'm backing up Chameleon, Moleon and Chaga, by that time, getting a dance of backing and a dance of Iga. So radio steps in. And Chameleon, yo, you can even join my backup crew, like Tanko Kuyimbanga Fena. Netfunane night, yalinga ku Blue Africa, if you remember that time.
Yeah, I remember Blue Africa.
Yeah, and the tank hang of backing a Chameleon, ngatumu backing a. Sometimes, ngeje tuwa kwata kama ne radio, nga sometimes we manye via night, you can't be there like all the time. Usolo kubea ngo ina show over Canada, but nenga night you know get going a mass.
Yeah.
So nitan kango kuyimba
nga Chameleon tali
wo abatali wo nga fetu nchingi nga tukola chi nga tuchikola.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ne waita wixinga biri.
Ne tufuka ba kabi.
Yeah. Ne tukirira mu studio.
Studio chi.
Studio ya Tulangira Sun.
Yes.
Kati wetu genda mu studio. Then the guy plays. There was some guys singing there. But the guys were singing, I don't know, playfully. Then the guy says, you guys, can you just sing on this track?
That time, it was a gospel song.
It was a gospel song. So guys were singing.
Can you just flow in this track?
I don't track here.
Then the fire just started from there. That day we sang two songs. We sang another one,
Rachonomia.
That very day, we sang Rachonomia. It was also a track. Those guys were supposed to do, but were doing very badly.
These guys?
We don't remember them. They were just sitting there. Near even the guy said,
you can have it.
Baby, my guy. What do you call him? Rasta. Even the guy is the one who suggested for the second track. You know, we have another track.
Yeah. I think we are missing. We didn't please. You can have
two tracks.
Guys, I'm so bad. You cannot remember.
Whoever
you are out there, you jump started this. You jump started the track business. Bad.
So, Katia, Muli, Muvera Babiri, and Yimba Zifurumi, Chameleon in Gadi Wow. Chameleon
in Gadi. Kati. Somewhere so, at that time we were working together with Chameleon. But we after some little time we had some kind of heated situations. So somehow we fell apart. But it was just
we
have too much strength. I don't know, Chiara. You have just become a star. You don't know how to handle it. You don't know how to, so much is going on.
So 10 years. So now 2007.
Yeah.
Chameleon, Mugambi, okay. Tufudeyo. How do you then start? Does now, Jeff come in the picture there?
Now Jeff he was managing Chameleon by that time. Chameleon had already fallen out with Changa. So it was Jeff managing that time. So we fall out with Chameleon, but we are meanwhile we are staying in the same house.
With Chameleon?
No, with Jeff.
Ah,
but okay. Jeff is still working with Chameleon.
Ah.
So Jeff is telling us to go back to Joseph. For us, we don't want to go back. We have our own differences. So when somehow maybe he could not agree with Chameleon about what had happened between us as a family, as a music family, he started maybe feeling that he needed to come and hang with these young people, to help them, I don't know. Because we are friends, we have been friends from time immemorial. So, and we are staying in the same house. We still get, if we have to eat, it is the same plate we share. So,
which year was it, Jeff?
Me, when I joined Leonard, and
he was there.
Chiwanuka was friends with Joseph.
Okay.
I just met them together.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, Jeff, so it must have been hard for him. Okumanaging eri Chameleon.
Sweeter than cuckoo, heart attack, potential, where you are.
Who does that?
Okay, so Good Life
yeah.
became a limited company and Jeff became a shareholder with both of you. Was that the deal or it was just...
No, it was just...
It was freestyle.
What would you change the 10 years?
Me, what I would change about the 10 years is how much time I've spent trying to argue and fight with people who do not agree with what I'm doing, do not agree with what I want, because I would have spent all that time and told you like what I'm doing right now, because usually there will always be somebody out there to talk about what you have done, because those people who talk about what you have done, they are doing nothing. So I did not recognize such an important fact until just now, when it's 10 years, they say, okay, what have I been doing with these people? They cannot defeat you. They are too weak.
Yeah, you know, like,
they can only talk about like what you have
this
done.
Season,
they don't do anything.
This season, there have been artists who like top hits. They have even survived for a year, just 6 months. Now they are hustling like they've been working like for 7 years. So we have a reason to celebrate on the 3rd of November at Shadondo. Imagine hit after hit for 10 years.
And we are not yet dying.
10 years and we are not yet giving up. Yeah.
So when you look back, you know, some of your biggest achievements in the 10 years, what will those be? Top three?
top three in the 10 years I've managed to move my mom from Omuzigo to a mansion. Big up, Kasubo. Large up on yourself.
Where is this house?
It's in Chitende side.
Chitende side.
Hey. One day I'll take you there and see about it.
All right, so the next 10 years.
Yes,
some of the three things, personal and the other three as a group.
Yeah.
What are you looking at? What's in the plan now?
Personally, well, I think I want to go back to school. Mm. I want to go back to school to study sound engineering, maybe. Mm. And I want to study some art also. Mm. I want to awaken my skill a bit, you know. I need to go and meet those skilled people. Mm. So maybe I want to go back to school. Okay. Yeah.
That's one. Get married.
Not very soon. My friend, I'm not going to get married very soon. At least for that one, I still want to give it some time.
You don't want to be selfish.
Yeah, because most people they spend a lot more time in a relationship and very little time as married people. So let's spend more time in a relationship.
Yeah, I don't want to be selfish. There are lots of people who like me. Why should I be with one?
You should be. I want to do farming. Of course, I've already started, but I want to be a serious farmer. I've had Lima Lunda Gagawala, so I also want to Gagawala and Lima and Lunda.
There's a time I was buying some land in Rwanda, and you're also buying land in Rwanda. Yes. So what are you doing with that land in Rwanda as well?
I'm going to do farming. No. In Rwanda, I'm going to do something else. Mm. It's not very huge for farming, so I'm going to do something else, a small project for kids, a play area for kids. Ah, yeah, that's what I'm planning.
And I'll be the first customer.
Ah, yeah, of course. Yours, the buy now membership. Membership for life.
Every time you bring a new one.
They have membership. Those are, and you know they are photocopies, so
easily tell. Mayanja one, Mayanja two, Mayanja three.
Yeah.
And then for the group,
my friend, for the group, it's a very big thing. We want to do international business most, so that we can better feed the world with our talent. Yeah. We have been feeding them, but on small scale, like you shoot two videos or three videos. So now we are partnering with the international team, you know, so we work in tandem. Everyone, we're working with Warner Brothers, Sony Music. Yeah. Working with most of the artists from other countries, not only in Africa. We are networking now, so we want it to be very big, because they love our music, but not everyone, you know. So you need to incorporate everybody. That's what I'm trying to plan with my brother here, to do for the team. Now focus internationally, you know. We sing locally, but think internationally. And then think locally and sing internationally. So we can market ourselves better. Yeah, sure.
Okay. Wizard, how many kids do you have?
I have enough.
You have enough?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
So you by the way, I have three kids.
Ah.
For sure. Not like three kids.
Three kids.
You'll be amazed.
The radio arm says like...
For sure.
No, I'm not like... Bit.
I'm not like... I have six.
Ah.
Okay. Yeah, he even has more kids.
I have six, but no further questions.
Okay.